So today we're talking about the importance of hormone balance. So first off, I want you to start with just, when do you see these kinds of hormone imbalances?
Oh, well, if we can remember back to what it was like to be in puberty, you know, many of us probably don't want to remember what it was like to be back in puberty. But when we first begin to get those surges of estrogen and progesterone, oh my goodness, it can take a while for those to settle down. For those, you know, those of our listeners who have maybe granddaughters or even children that they can remember what it was like living with them when they were going through puberty, it was because they were having a surge of estrogen. And then there was a surge of progesterone, or it could have just been a surge of estrogen, but not enough progesterone. And estrogen was dominant. And there are all those symptoms that come from having that imbalance in your estrogen and your progesterone. So these can start as early as puberty. And then depending on how our genetic makeup is, depending on, you know, how we exercise, what we eat, you know, we can make life easier for ourselves as we go through our reproductive years, and things can settle down. And, you know, maybe people get a little bit of PMS, you know, the really unfortunate ones, the ones who are super sensitive to estrogen, that surge of estrogen, and oh my goodness, all their symptoms in the second half of their cycle. Our poor souls. I'm so glad I was not in that category.
Yes, I was.
When it comes, I know you were. I can't imagine what that would it was like to have been so affected by that. What was that like?
Well, I mean, I was diagnosed with endometriosis, which I later learned is functionally an estrogen dominance disease, and it's pretty prevalent actually. But you know, in the early stages, what was really apparent is I would get incredibly tender breasts before my period started. And I had, you know, 10, 11 day periods that were incredibly heavy and excruciatingly painful. And I just remember sitting in high school, you know, the dumb little desks with just my head on my desk and just like hunkered over as tight as I could be. And when I was 19, I started to have non-cycle pain. So off-cycle pain, probably more around ovulation. So again, that's a period when estrogen's pretty much at its apex, right? And so I would have incredible pain that would just double me over, and I'd have to just go sleep it off. But yes, and so estrogen dominance has been something I've worked with through much of my reproductive years. And so I was actually kind of excited about menopause because I thought this would be behind me. Little did I know it could introduce all sorts of new issues. So.
Right, right. Well, that's a great example because there are way more women who experience some form of estrogen dominance than is ever really documented. They just kind of hunker down and suck it up. So some women can experience that throughout their reproductive years. But the real crunch seems to come around perimenopause. And as we've talked about in our progesterone video, we have a long video on progesterone for anyone who's interested. That's really when the big imbalance starts to occur, when we still have plenty of estrogen because we're still making that the first half of the cycle. But because we're not ovulating every time, we don't make the progesterone to balance that out. And so you can be estrogen dominant for like 21 days out of the month. You know, you can get periods that go on for, you know, 7, 8, 9, 10 days, heavy, uncomfortable, crampy periods, a lot of mood swings during this time. I mean, the list is long, and I know we've covered it in other discussions, but it's to do with this balance. And so, you know, progesterone is what we lose first, and it's the first one that we want to kind of backfill with supplementation as we move into perimenopause. And then as we transition through menopause and into postmenopause, we don't need as much necessarily postmenopause, but we still need some.
Again, it's getting that back into balance. So you talked about finding balance during reproductive years, during basically perimenopause and some of those early transition stages. But after menopause, I mean, we are in balance once everything drops to the bottom, aren't we? I mean, why do anything then?
Right. We're in balance because there's nothing on either side. But that is not optimally healthy because we have so many receptors for estrogen and progesterone, not just in our uterus, not just in our breast tissue. We have receptors all over the place, particularly in the brain, but in our bones too, in our gut. And so postmenopause, if we end up with no or very little production of these hormones, then there's a whole host of other knock-on effects and symptoms can occur. So think about this like a teeter-totter. You know, a teeter-totter, when it functions, does this. It goes backwards and forwards on a fulcrum, kind of point in the middle. Now, if you have no hormones at all, you've just got a plank on the ground with no fulcrum, and you've got no activity going on there at all. Now, you might want to add a little bit of Silky peach cream because that's going to resolve the vaginal dryness. But if you do that, you're going to be out of balance there. So you might want to add some progesterone so that you've got your Silky peach cream estriol and your vibrant through progesterone in balance. Now, it's more than about balance, because when you add these hormones in, the benefits are felt actually throughout the whole body. So balance is the starting point, and it's the value that it brings to your overall health as well.
Do you want to just list a few of those impacts to your overall health from having progesterone and estrogen in balance?
Oh my goodness, this is just always one of my favorite things to talk about because there are so many things. All right, so bone strength. It's critically important that we stay strong and healthy and our bones are strong and healthy. We all have horror stories of an elderly aunt or mother even who has fallen. And once she fell and broke bones, it was very hard for her to bounce back from that. So keeping your bones strong and healthy is critical. And both estrogen and progesterone are important for that. Both estrogen and progesterone are important for heart health, for cardiovascular health as well. We've got to keep our heart pumping. You know, it has to work every second of every day for the rest of our lives. And so anything we can do to keep our heart working healthily, we should act on that. And both estrogen and progesterone can help with that. Digestion, progesterone in particular, is very good for helping with our digestive tract. It helps calm the digestive tract and so that we don't end up with spasms in there. Progesterone is really good for glucose and insulin control. So someone who has a tendency to love on those sweets and candies and cookies, progesterone can help balance your blood sugar so that you don't end up with cravings. Oh, cognition, memory, a functioning brain. Oh my goodness. I think one of the things I fear more than anything in life is, you know, not being able to remember things, not being able to learn things, not being able to, you know, hold fun conversations. I am personally doing everything I can to make sure my brain stays as strong and robust as it can do for a long time. And both progesterone and estrogen can help with that too. I mean, I can go on. And I know we have some blog topics on this, but those probably are my top three for now.
That's great. Now, we do, obviously, with our Silky Peach Cream and Vibrant Third, we give some recommendations for women on how to start using it, how to start bringing it in balance. But every woman's different. So is there anything more you'd like to say about, you know, finding your own personal balance as an individual?
Yes. When people start with Silky Peach Cream and the progesterone cream, or even the Chaos Calmer as well, it's going to be a bit of a journey to understand what works for you. It'll take a little bit of experimentation. So Our instructions have those general guidelines, but you know what your hormone history has been like. You know what the rest of your health profile is like. You know how much you exercise or don't. You know how much water you drink or don't on a daily basis. So you are the person who is in charge in calibrating, I'm going to use my hands again, calibrating the right amount of estriol for your vaginal health with Silky Peach Cream and the right amount of progesterone for, you know, serving your whole body in a positive way.
So what I'm taking away from this really is hormone balance is not a one-size-fits-all operation. There is going to be an adjustment period as you try to find what works for you. Mm-hmm. And for me, as someone mm-hmm. who's been estrogen dominant my whole life, I need to keep my ratio of Silky Peach Cream considerably lower than my intake of progesterone.
Yeah. So, you know, while some women are really hyper-responsive to estrogen in general, like you, who can't use estradiol at all, there are many women who don't have that hyper response. They're able to use the estradiol that they get from their practitioner, and they're able to add in some of the Silky Peach Cream, the estriol cream as well, because that's the right match for them. So one thing I would add is that, you know, we have our private Facebook group, this mm-hmm. incredibly supportive environment, safe, private environment for our women to discuss these issues. And what I've noticed is that, you know, people will pile in with their experiences. The big advantages of that is that everyone else gets to see how different everybody's experience is. Mm-hmm. I know sometimes someone will say, oh, I've done this, you should do this. It's like, well, it's helpful to know that they have done taken a particular action, and then you can take that away and file it away and read other comments and then do your own experimenting on what is right for you.
So in some of our blogs, we do talk more about, you know, signs that maybe you have too much estrogen or not enough, and too much progesterone or not enough, which can really help in finding your own balance. So I encourage you all to take a look at our blogs. I'll put some in the show notes about where to find those. And hopefully you found this helpful. And I also just want to make a quick plug that if you have specific questions, always feel free to email us at kate@parlor-games.com. Often those do get handled by Kate herself. And also just to make clear, we're not doctors, and so we are not going to be able to diagnose. But we can, Kate in particular, who has a lot of knowledge in this area, can give some feedback on perhaps experiments to try for yourself.
All righty.